Guys, we're back. We're going to Sheep Meadow with Dan and his 13-year-old son, Nick. This is his first time backpacking, so we're gonna break him in. It's starting to rain a little bit, so I'm not sure how much we'll get from the trail, but we'll try to get some in. It is 7:13, and we have made it to Sheep Meadow, which is not much of a meadow. There's the other lean-to. We're gonna be staying here. We have a fire pit. It's been raining pretty good. I'm probably gonna go back that way, put my hammock up. Private pile, 0300 infantry, you made it. I got my Tokes 850 going again on the old homemade fancy feast alcohol stove. 2 cups of water for Packet Gourmet Dottie's chicken and dumplings. That is, I've got the mix and the sauce over there. Waiting for the hot water. Dan and Nick have already ripped up their little stove. Dan's really boils water about 3 minutes. 2 cups. They've got the old Mountain House rice and chicken times 2. Coming in for a close up on the rehydrated rice and chicken. Notice that is rice and chicken, not chicken and rice.
Yeah. It's flavoring.
Nick's got the same thing.
I'm practically empty.
Boy's hungry.
Boy's hungry, yeah.
That's his first hike. How'd you do? How do you feel?
Well, after sitting down for a bit, I feel like I want to walk more for some reason.
Yeah, go ahead. Walk down there and get me some water. Here is the Dottie's Chicken and Dumplings from Packet Gourmet. We are, it's late now, folks. It started to rain, so we got dinner and got the hammock hung up. The fire is actually doing quite well, despite the rain. We'll probably be heading to bed shortly. It's a little after 10. Smoke cloud, Dan's smoking a cigar over there. A little smoke cloud Dan's room. Nick did good on his first hike. 13 years old. Hauled in about 40 pounds.
Easy 40 pounds.
Hey guys, it is 11:15 and I'm in the hammock for the night. Set up not too far from the lean-to where Dan and Nick are. Been raining pretty steady, not heavily, but steady since we got here. So didn't do a lot of filming. So I'm getting ready to head in for the night. And hopefully tomorrow it'll be a little drier and I can give you a tour of the Sheep Meadow. Alright guys, it's 6:54 a.m. on Saturday. Did not sleep well last night. Rained all night long, still rained a little bit. I'm dry, that's good. But I did not sleep well. I'm going to have to take a nap later, but I'm hungry, so I can hear Dan and Nick are up, so go over there and have some breakfast, see what's going on. This is a Mountain House breakfast skillet. Onions, peppers, hash browns, sausage. Yeah, it looks all right. Let's give her a go. All right.
Ooh, pretty good.
My biscuits and gravy is in the cozy. I love biscuits and gravy. Mm-hmm. Mountain House. Okay, guys, seems like the rain has abated slightly. That is the trail that we came in on right there. You probably can barely even see it. We'll turn around. There is our fire pit last night. This is the lean-to that we stayed in. Dan's in there taking a nap. That is lean-to number 2 with its fire pit, and down in the distance there is the horse barn. We'll go down in there later. Hopefully things are going to dry out here a little bit. I can go down there and give you a little tour of that. If we keep going down this way, of course there's the fire pit I mentioned, and The logbook for the shelters is in that little box. That was a guy's kid's Boy Scout project back in early 2000s. If you go down this way, the water source is down there. There's a barn back down there again to the left. See down this little trail. I believe the water source is down there. I heard it running last night. Up this way is the lean-to, or not the lean-to, the outhouse. Here comes Nick. Just took care of business. Can make it out of there all right?
I made it.
This is the sheep meadow, okay? Doesn't look much like a meadow anymore. We are loaded with blueberries. As you can see, we've actually got some that are ready to go. Yep, not bad. It's loaded with blueberries up here. They probably should rename this Sheep's Thicket or something, because there's the lean-to, back of the lean-to. There's no meadow here anymore. We kind of suspected that we were going to walk into a meadow, because that was the last information I had, was that it was still a meadow. But it is not. So here we go. Here is the horse barn. A nice long sandy area here. Oh, there's buckets in case you want to drag those buckets down to the stream, which is down beyond here and not very easy to get to. It's down a scramble, but here you go. Horse barn, we got 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I'm gonna try that again. 1, 2, 3, 4. We got 6 stalls. Food trough. And you have 6 more on this side. I mean, worst comes to worst, you could camp in here. I actually thought about hanging a hammock from the rafters. I mean, I could have climbed up there and hung one off of that rafter and then come down here somewhere and hung one off that rafter and hung right here in this alley. If worst come to worst. It didn't, even though it rained all last night. Stayed fairly dry. My tent, my tarp loosened up a little bit, so I got a little splashing from that. I had to get up in the middle of the night anyway, take care of business, and I adjusted it, and everything seemed okay this morning. Now the water source is down behind here, down in the valley. So if you're ever up here, it's down there, but it's a bushwhack. There's not really any obvious trail that I found that goes all the way down there. Little stream. Oddly enough, I believe that's called Dan Brook. No relation to the Dan that is with us today. So it's finally cleared up. It's 1:30, about noon. The clouds finally broke and we had clear skies. So we're trying to dry our shoes and whatnot out that got wet on the way in. I think I'll pick a few blueberries, not too many, but there we go. Otherwise, it's getting warm now. It's warming up. It's probably going to be in the 80s, I think. Just going to chill out. We took a little nap because none of us slept real good last night, so autofocus is the auto explosion. None of us slept real good last night, so went back about 8:30 and took a nap till 11:30. So hopefully I'm not up half the night tonight. So that's the horse barns. Pretty cool. I bet there's not too many of those in the Adirondacks. I don't know if you guys can see that, but that to me looks like claw marks. So I wonder if that looks like hatchet marks there, but if that was somebody trying to be smart to make it look like claw marks, or if we've got wildlife up here. This little fire tower, with a little help from us, he took some advice and didn't listen to other advice, so we're gonna see how well he does with his little fire tower. It has been raining. It rained for about 12 hours straight, so. Don't be afraid to give it a little oxygen. There you go, there you go.
There you go. Come on, follow the paper, follow the paper. Oh, no,
I think you're done. Careful, don't burn yourself.
There's the paper. Oh. I lit a little bit more than I wanted to, but.
Well, that wind didn't help you.
No, it did not.
No, we're not done yet. Now you're done. You're gonna knock that whole tower over. You know, you're getting aggressive in there.
Which aggression?
Give it a minute. I can't even see the flame.
Sun's on it. Stand over it. There you go. You're good.
There we go. Perfect. Come on. Need the paper to go. Go, paper, go.
Might happen.
I hope it does. I don't want to back up.
And you're out.
Oh! The paper just keeps burning to me.
Like this. Light this up. Stick that in the end.
Oh my god, you saw a flame.
Stick it in as far as you can.
Try and. It won't budge.
I'm getting a real good flame. There you go. And your paper is damp too.
There we go. Come on. Bring it, baby. Burn.
Not enough flame to get those going.
Well, there is a flame inside there somewhere because it keeps smoking even when it goes out. Even after it goes out.
You got a little bit of a coal, but not much. Nope. You may have to come up with a new strategy. Everything's wet, that's a challenge. We'll check back in on Nick later if he see where he, if he's been successful. Guys, I'm gonna take you back and show you my little setup. Back here, lays from the lean-to. Of course, I've got the Warbonnet Blackbird, the Edge Tarp, Dutch Continuous Ridgeline. If you've watched the other videos, you've heard all this before. Inside is the Arrowhead Equipment New River Underquilt. Up underneath, in there, that blue thing is the New River top quilt. And now I'm going to attempt to take a nap.
Moving too fast. Oops.
there.
Yeah, we're getting ready to cook dinner. We got did some wood preparation for later. That'll just be the fire. We're using the alcohol stove, and Dan's got his what is that thing called again?
Optimus Cruise.
Yeah. That thing cooks fast, man. Boils 2 cups of water in like 3 minutes. It's crazy. We've got some storm clouds coming. I don't know if you can see them there. So I have a feeling we're in for another rainy night. But
in that case, I better get my fire going.
Blueberry and fern heaven. Fry up some fiddleheads if you got here early. When these were all coming up. But another month or so, there'll be blueberries like crazy. And probably black bears.
We've got a mountain house, macaroni and cheese, and I have diced up a Spam single, the light version. And I'm going to put that in there and let that warm up a little bit more. And we'll see how that is. Nick has got beef stew for mountain house.
Oh yeah, that smells real good too. Nice. Dan's having the same thing. It's all right, Dan?
It's good.
Okay, folks, you're looking at, that is filtered water out of the Dan Creek down there. That does not have any iced tea in it. That is the color of the water. Up here in the Adirondacks, and we have trees that put what they call tannin into the water. It's actually the basis for what they used to tan leather with. So, but it's perfectly safe to drink. But that's what it looks like. Adirondack tea doesn't really give it any kind of flavor.
Oh, Nick tried for a long time. He rebuilt his fire and he tried for a couple hours and just wasn't having any luck with that soaked wood. But we got a little magic fix. Now that's a fire there. I'm not going to divulge my secret, but we should be all right now.
All right, here we go. We're playing a glow-in-the-dark ring toss. I'm up. Bad shot. I'm trying to hold the camera and ring toss at the same time.
Oh, that was close.
Those look really cool, actually.
Morning, everybody. It's 7:15 on Sunday the 19th, and we're going to have a little breakfast, pack up, and head out. Okay, guys, it is now 8:30, and we are heading out. The rain has picked up again, and we're getting some thunder. So, I'm not sure how much videotaping I will do, or recording, whatever you want to call this, on the way. We've got 3.4 miles back to the car. So, Nick and Dan have set out ahead of me, because I take such a long time to pack. There they are. Nick is prepared for foul weather. Dan and I are taking our chances. Dan is heavily armed with a .22. No need of that. No sign of bears or coyotes or anything. I do think I heard a loon early this morning. So, that was cool. I always like to hear the loons. All right, well, if I don't see you, we'll see you back at the car.
Well, we are almost to the trail register on the way out. It rained real heavy. Got ourselves a nice little walk in the thunder and lightning. Maybe a half an hour, but right now we're almost to the car. Everybody's still alive. I'm gonna go over here and sign out.
We are back in the vehicle on our way home. Nick is back there. How'd it go, Nick?
Well, it was really rainy. Do not bring a jacket.
It was warm though.
Yeah.
But you made it, your first time.
First hike?
You made it. Congratulations.